We have seen, I'd say, some very interesting things over the past 15 years in electronic voting and electronic voting security.
When we're talking about the use of these machines and the problems with them, they go back a really long time. Optical scan machines had been used since the 60s and 70s. Some touchscreen machines were already being used in the late 90s.
And I think all of you remember the iconic photo of an election official in Florida with a magnifying glass looking at hanging chads.
So let me talk about my frustration with 2016, right? We're only talking about this because it's Russians, right? The problems have existed, like I said, going back to at least 2000.
But there's another story here that I think is incredibly important for those of us that live and breathe cybersecurity, and it's the infrastructure of voting.
Are machines really disconnected from the internet? It turns out they're not really. Many of these machines are transmitting results on election night and they're using modems to transmit the results.
Voting machines are declared critical infrastructure. Everything seems to be fixed. Is that your assessment?
There's a movement now toward audits, right? And which is really the solution that we need at this point. And I don't think that the voting activists fully recognized what they were getting into and just asking for the paper trail. What they really needed was a full-size paper ballot and mandatory audits.
What could the average citizen do to help the current state of play?
Volunteer as a poll worker and become engaged in the process in that way and get your election officials to know who you are. So I think that if you really sort of express a sincere interest in trying to understand the processes that they go through and putting in the time and effort to actually understand their job and then offer advice, that's probably the best way to get into it.